Hello everyone, welcome back to Aspen Tech channel. So today we will do the process flow sheeting, and for this we are choosing the example of production of cyclohexane from benzene and hydrogen. We have already simulated this process in Aspen Hyses. I will give its link in the description, and now we will do the simulation part in Aspen Plus as was requested by valuable viewers. So this is the overall flow sheet of the process. The benzene and hydrogen are the feed streams are initially mixed and they are preheated. Followed by the preheating, they are sent to the reactor where the reaction takes place, that C6H6 reacts with 3 moles of hydrogen to produce cyclohexane. Then the mixture is sent, or the product is sent to the flash separator where the flashing phenomena takes place, the vapor product is produced and the liquid product is produced. The part of the vapor product is purged, while the remaining portion or the major portion is recycled and is mixed with the feed, while the liquid stream, part of it is recycled, while majority of it, which contains high purity cyclohexane, is fed to the column. And in this column, we obtained vapor product and liquid product. And in this liquid product, which is labeled as bottom, we get the 99% pure cyclohexane. So this is the overall flow sheet of the process. We will simulate it in the two ways, number one without recycle and number two with recycle. So these are the feed specifications of benzene: the temperature of 100 degree Fahrenheit, pressure 335 psia, flow rate 100 pound mole per hour with composition as benzene 1. While for hydrogen, temperature is 120 degree Fahrenheit, pressure 335 psia, flow rate 310 pound mole per hour, composition of hydrogen 0.975, methane 0.02 and nitrogen 0.005. It means that we have to enter benzene, hydrogen, methane, nitrogen and cyclohexane as our components in Aspen Plus. Then going to heater, the specification of heater or the preheater is 300 degree Fahrenheit and 330 psia. For reactor, the outlet temperature is 400 degree Fahrenheit with a pressure drop of minus 15 psia, and the reaction is 1 mole of benzene reacts with 3 moles of hydrogen to produce cyclohexane. C6H6 plus 3H2 produces C6H12. And since we are using the conversion reactor, our stoic, so, or the stoichiometric reactor, we say in Aspen Plus, in Aspen Hyses, we say conversion reactor, while here we say stoichiometric reactor. So 99.8% conversion of benzene. For the separator, the specifications given are temperature of 120 degree Fahrenheit, while the pressure of 310 psia. Split 1, 93% of the feed is recycled. Split 2, 25% of the feed is recycled. And in the column specification, the total number of stages are 15, feed stage 8, reflux ratio 1.3, distillate flow rate 5 kmol per hour, the condenser pressure is 300 psia, reboiler pressure is 310 psia, and the required cyclohexane purity is 99.86%. So majority of the conditions are the same as we have simulated in Aspen Hyses, but since these two interfaces are a bit different in some aspects, so these aspects are covered here in this picture. So we will go now to the Aspen Plus. We will first add the components, then we will add the property package, then we will do the flow sheeting, and once after giving the flow sheeting or doing the flow sheeting, the process will be quite simple, that we have to give the inputs as I have shown you now. So we will first add the components: benzene, hydrogen, nitrogen, methane and CB. Although it is cyclohexane. So once after adding all these components, click next and select Peng Robinson as property package. Again, click next and click run. And now go to the simulation environment once results are available. So we will now first add the equipments over here, and for the proper flow sheeting, we will select grid, snap and scale. So now first one is to install is a mixer, as we have seen here, then the heater block, which is shown over here, then the reactor, which is the stoichiometric reactor in this system, which is shown over here or clicked over here, then the flash separator, obviously it's the flash two separator is added over here, then the two splitters, which are selected in this case, number one and number two in this case, and followed by the distillation column. So I have already shown you the procedure do the flow sheeting, and now I will simply show you how the flow sheeting is done in this system. So as you can see, the blocks are now aligned and are properly connected. The benzene stream and the hydrogen stream, these are initially mixed. They are sent to the preheater where their temperature is increased. Then they are sent to the reactor, followed by the flashing. The top product partly is purged, but majority is recycled. First we will do without recycling, and then we will add the recycled portion. So obviously for without recycle, this stream cannot be connected here. And similarly for this liquid stream, this stream is initially produced, but once we will go to the with recycle, we will connect it to the mixer, and the majority of the stream is going to this column. So now we will look at one by one, and we will see what are the specifications required and how we can converge it. So first click on benzene stream. I have already given the data here: 100 degree Fahrenheit, 335 psia, 100 pound mole per hour, and benzene mole fraction as 1. Then going to hydrogen, and for hydrogen, 120 degree Fahrenheit, 335 psia, 310 pound mole per hour, with mole fraction of hydrogen as 0.975, nitrogen 0.005, and methane as 0.02. And as you know, the degree of freedom for mixer is 0. It means we do not need to specify any variable in the mixer. Then going to this heater, and as you know that to make its degree of freedom of 0, we need to specify two variables. So these two variables are temperature and pressure. Temperature of 300 degree Fahrenheit, pressure of 330 psia are specified. Then in the reactor, again the degree of freedom is, this specification is 2. So temperature of 400 degree Fahrenheit and a pressure drop of minus 15 psi is given in the statement. And we have added the reactions over here. And as you can see, benzene minus 1 coefficient, hydrogen minus 3 coefficient, cyclobenzene coefficient of 1, and fractional conversion 0.998 of benzene in the system. So stoichiometric reactor, we have already simulated it. I will give its link as well in the pop-up. And then the flash separator, again degree of freedom is 0 when we have specified two variables. So these are temperature and pressure, 120 degree Fahrenheit and 310 psia. Then in the splitter, we have been given that 93% of the feed to the split is recycled. So it means either we can specify a purge as 0.07, or we can specify recycle as 93%. Similarly, in the second case, which is the split 2, 25% of the feed to the split 2 is recycled, or we can say 75% of the feed is sent to the distillation column. And in the distillation column, we have been given 15 number of stages. Since it's a vapor outlet or vapor distillate, so we will specify condenser type as partial vapor, partial condenser with vapor distillate only. The distillate rate given to us is 5k mole per hour. Reflux ratio is 1.3 mole in mole. In streams, the feed stream is 8, which is above stage. And in the pressure, which is a pressure profile, the condenser pressure is 300 psia and the reboiler pressure is 310 psia. So once after giving all the required specifications, we can now simply click on the run button and run our simulation. And once after simulation is run, results are available, and we can simply, like this one is given to us, so we can simply see what are the column results, because these are the results which will be important. So as you can see, 99.8% of cyclohexane is produced in the bottom, while the remaining stream, which is a vapor product, which contains cyclobenzene as well and other streams as well. But currently this system is without recycle, and our requirement is to produce 99.86%. So what are the procedures that we will first recycle it, and if the specification is met, then it's okay. If specification is not met, then we will apply the design spec. So what we will do, we will click here and we will connect it over here by ensuring that our requirement is met, and then again clicking over here, and obviously we can do the alignment part as well, and simply reset it and again run it. And once after running, you can again see the results which are available now, and you can see in the results that 99.86% cyclohexane, which was our requirement, is now met. And as you can see, on the other hand, The cyclohexane, which was earlier around 70%, is now reduced to 64%. So obviously, when you recycle the streams and when you once you do the recycling process, the process becomes efficient. And as we have seen over here, that the percentage purity of cyclohexane is increased in the required stream, which was the bottom stream of this product, and the cyclohexane, which was wasting in the distillate, is now recovering back in the system. So that's how we simulate cyclohexane production process in Aspen Plus. Obviously, we can do a bit of rearrangement part over here as well. And obviously, this one is again dependent on you, which nomenclature you select or which type of alignment you want. Simply, you have to go here in view, grid, snap, scale, and obviously, which one grid you want. It is clearly up to you. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, and share the video and subscribe to the channel Aspen Tech. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.